My t-shirt says schizotypal personality disorder. That's one of my diagnoses. It's not the most disabling of my diagnoses, but it's definitely one of my diagnoses. And I want to say again that I really wanted a diagnosis. My behavior was clearly outside the normal range. But when I asked shrinks, what is wrong with me? I couldn't get an answer. They would say things like they didn't want to get into labels. But you need a label. You've got to have a label so people will know what it is they're dealing with. Because without a diagnosis, I was left to tell people I have emotional problems. Said nothing. Person invariably says, we all do. And then I do something that we all don't. And it's held against me, even though it was a function of a disorder. And a lot of times I may appear rude, ill-mannered. I can, in fact, people can be misled into thinking I'm arrogant. Me? Because they don't know what is wrong with me. And I was really, really pleased when I finally got a diagnosis. My original diagnosis was schizotypal personality disorder with obsessive and compulsive features. And I also have a diagnosis that I saw in a psychiatrist's office of impulse control disorder. The most disabling is impulse control disorder because when I was 14 years old, I started having attacks of extreme rage, sometimes combined with terror. They could be attacks of rage, terror, attacks of rage. And one of the odd things about it, people expect somebody who's enraged to be screaming and yelling and maybe hitting people. After a while, I would go through rages and nobody could see anything. I felt it. And I was distracted by it. It was inside, a murderous rage, but it was trapped inside. Okay. And that's something that people weren't aware of. They didn't understand why I couldn't remember this or that, or why I wasn't paying attention. I couldn't pay attention. A murderous rage had gone off inside of me, and it was trapped inside of me. They couldn't see it, but I sure as hell felt it. And so I'll talk about this more in the future, but I think I've said enough to get you to understand why I needed a diagnosis and why much of my life has been deformed by my mental illnesses. Hope you like hearing that.